Hello and welcome to the episode of Introduction to Application Layer Protocols. Before we proceed to the prescribed syllabus, let us have an understanding about the data communication system and the networks, and followed by the principles related to the application layer and the models that are been governing the application layer principles. What is a data communication system? It is a system which contains several components to transmit the data from one place to another place. In this diagram, you can understand that data is being transmitted from one end of a location to another end of the location. Basically, the data communication is the exchange of data between a source and a receiver via a transmission media. At one end of the location, you have a sender which is sending the data to be transmitted using a transmission media to the other end of the location. For the other end, we have a component called receiver, which receives the data and gives the necessary information to the corresponding user. Several times, even the receiver at the other end can be acting like a sender, which the other end user tries to transmit some data to the another end, and the other end you have a receiver which tries to perform the same process to provide the information what is being transmitted across this communication media to the respective users. So a device which is acting like a sender as well as a receiver is being termed as a transceiver. So the transceivers are being used to communicate between two different locations to exchange the data between different entities. Now, if you look to this diagram, these transceivers are being connected by a transmission media. Basically, the transmission media will be either wired or a wireless communication medium. So in today's technology, most of the communication is happening through the wireless media. At the one end of the system, you see that the information that needs to be exchanged is transformed into another form before the actual transmission takes place. So at both the ends, you have different steps, in other terms, different methods that needs to be performed in properly exchanging the data from one end of the location to another end of the location. The process of transforming the information or the message to an appropriate form is done with the help of certain rules, which we term it as basically the protocols. So the basic components of a data communication system are, we have the sender, which is trying to transmit the data, and the receiver, which is trying to receive the data, and the actual message, which is getting transmitted across the different entities with the help of a transmission media, which can tries to provide a via media to communicate between the two entities, and the protocol, which are governing the transformation of information or the data in an appropriate form. Similarly, with respect to the web communication, we have a similar scenario where basically a web is a collection of interconnected documents and resources. The documents and the resources are getting exchanged between different entities which are located at different places. So at one end of the location, we have an entity called client, and at the other end, we have an entity called server. And this client and server communication is happening for exchange of those documents or the resources. In simple terms, the messages and informations are getting exchanged between these two entities by following the components of the data communication system. As far as the web development is concerned, the web development requires the web communication, which includes the essentials such as the clients. So at one end, we have a certain components which are related to requesting the information which is located at a different place with the help of the browsers which are running on these clients. The browser is an application program which runs on this client and which helps us to retrieve the information which is located at some other place. On the other hand, you have the other entity called server systems, which are trying to address to the requests that have been made from different clients. The server systems do supply the information or the requested information which is located on that particular place. Supporting this client-server communication, we have a computer network which has got various entities and various protocols which are running in the process of exchanging the information between the clients and the servers. As far as the computer network is concerned, the most important points everyone should get a clarity is on the services and the protocols. So basically, a network is a set of devices connected by media links. So whenever there is an exchange of information from a user A to a user B with the help of a network, there are certain mechanisms that needs to be understood, such as what are called services and what are being called as protocols. A service can be a connectionless or a connection oriented. It means that a connection is established between a user A and a user B for the effective exchange of data between these two entities. Sometimes there not be any connection between these two entities. We call it as a connectionless. So when there is a connection which has been established between user A and user B, there will be a reliable communication. It means that the connection oriented establishment makes sure that the data or the messages that are exchanging between user A and user B are not getting lost. Whereas for a connectionless service that is existing between these set of users may lead to unreliable data communication. And the process of communication between the user A and user B is carried upon with the help of the rules that are to be followed by exchanging the data between these two entities. In order to have a proper connection establishment or for a proper transmission of data, there are certain primitives such as the request and the indications, responses, and the confirmation between these two entities are nothing but those service primitives which help us to have a proper connection to be established for the transmission of data between two entities. So looking to the operations of the services and the protocols, the network researchers have proposed various reference models to facilitate the network protocols and services. The network researchers have logically proposed a model called as Open Systems Interconnection, which is a standard model which consists of 7 layers. These layers correspond to various methods that are to be carried on before transmitting the data to the other end. So the data that needs to be transmitted from one end of a location to another end gets transformed to an appropriate form so that proper data transmission takes place. So the 7 layers reference model, which we call it as an open systems interconnection model, is basically a logical model which is proposed by the network researchers so that the data or the messages can be transmitted from one place to another place without any problems. But in practice, the researchers have come to a particular model which we call it as a 5 layers reference model, which consists of different steps or different layers in simple terms called as physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, and the application layer. So the first layer, which is being directly connected to the physical transmission media, is being termed as the physical medium or the physical layer. So the purpose of the physical layer is to transmit the data or that information or that messages in the form of binary bits. So the binary bits of information gets transmitted from one end of the location to another end of the location. So those binary bits get transmitted either through wired or wireless communication. With respect to the wired communication, the physical media or the physical transmission medium can be either electrical wires or in terms of coaxial cables, which can be twisted pair cables, or your Ethernet cables, which we call it as, or the wireless media, which follows certain radio signals to be used to transmit the data from one end to another end. With respect to the wired communication, today's technology supports the optical fiber cable, which acts like the physical media in transmitting the data from one end to the other end. So the optical fiber cable to process the data to be transmitted with the help of light signals. Above the physical layer, we have a data link layer where the bits of the information have been put together in the form of frames. A frame is nothing but a sequence of bits, which can be a fixed length frame or it can be a variable length frame. In order to have proper data flow communication between the sender and the receiver, which are connected by the same physical transmission media, the data link layer makes sure that the data is been flowing from one end to another and without any problems. Above the data link layer, we have another layer called as network layer. If the sender and the receiver are both not connected with the same physical media, it means they are located a distance apart, then the network layer comes into picture. In other terms, the unit of exchange of information that is happening from one end to another end with the help of this network layer is called as packet. A packet contains the sequence of bytes of information that is been put together to transmit from one end to another end, which are located a distance apart. Above the network layer, we have a layer called as transport layer. Whenever we require the data to be a reliable data communication or an unreliable data communication, then this particular layer will take care of transmitting the data with a connection-oriented principles and connection-less principles with respect to the reliability of the data transmission from one end to the other end. So coming to the application layer, where the data is being exchanged between the application layers in the form of application data units, which is from one end to the other end. So the application layers will help us to transmit from one end of the location to another end of the location, which takes care of the data structures and the semantic rules that need to be governed in properly presenting and properly formatting the data to be sent across this particular network. So in practice, these five layers of the reference model help us to transmit the data from the sender to the receiver by following certain protocols at each layer. In practice, the five layers reference model is transformed into a TCP/IP protocol model, which is been termed as Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol Suite. The conceptual theme of the client-server model is basically on this TCP/IP protocol model. So at the client side, we have the different steps that gets to be executed before the actual message being transmitted from the client to the server. Similarly, at the server side, there are different steps which gets to be executed in order to make sure that whatever the requested information from the client has come needs to be properly processed and give back the corresponding results to the client. So those steps are being given in the form of this four-layer TCP/IP protocol suite. So the five layers has been transformed to the four-layer model by making the combination of physical layer and the data link layer as one unit together, followed by the network layer is now being termed as the internet layer. And then above the internet layer, we have the transport layer, and above that, we have the application layer. So if you look to this four-layer model, which is also nothing but a subset of your seven layers OSI reference model, where the session layer and the presentation layer, the logical functionalities of them are being incorporated into your application layer. The protocols which are being carried upon on the respective layers are given here, but in the due course of our study, we'll try to understand what these protocols are trying to do. The client-server model is basically is nothing but which follows the TCP/IP suite, the protocol suite, so where the clients tries to get some information from a particular server by querying the servers. It means the messages, the query messages are being transmitted to the server, and the server gives the corresponding responses in the form of messages to the requested client. And these things are happening with the help of your network. So at the client side, all the four layers of your TCP/IP model gets executed here. And at the similarly, at the server side, the requested messages which have been sent from the client are get processed by following those four layers functionalities on the server side. So a server answers the queries received by clients, and they execute the commands from the clients, and many clients can use the same server to get the information what they are looking for. At the top layer of your TCP/IP protocol suite, we have something called as application layer protocols, or certain protocols which are needs to be related to the application layer, where the application layer is very close to the user. So the user, whenever he wants some information, he wants to query that information. If the user is at the client side, he tries to give the requested information with the application programs that will try to take that respective request and transform that particular requested information into an appropriate form, and they are being sent across this network and they are being received by the server. Similarly, the server process the request with respect to the queries that are being posed by the client, and the processed messages are being sent back to the respective clients to give the necessary outputs or the necessary information. So at the application layer, we have certain protocols, certain rules that are going to be followed before the actual request gets transformed to the transmission media of your network. So the application layer protocol basically takes care of what exactly the information the user is looking for, how the information should be presented, what type of information needs the client is looking for. So the application layer protocols takes care of the syntactical and the semantic rules that define the messages that needs to be exchanged between the client and the server, and in what order they needs to be processed. So the clients may request different types of information, such as an email or a file to be downloaded from a server, or an email to be seen by the client which is coming from a different server, or he likes to hear music and that music needs to be coming from a music server, or basically a file to be printed. So a particular message has to be printed. So with the help of a print server, that information gets to be exchanged. So there are different types of data that needs to be exchanged between the client and the server, and those different types of data, how that particular data has to be presented at the client side before the actual mechanism takes place is taken care by the application layer protocol. So please do remember, the application layer protocol takes care of the syntactical and the semantic rules. They're basically the protocols that define the messages that needs to be exchanged between the client and the server and in a corresponding order. The references for the slides is from this particular book, the Computer Networking. This book can be, the ebook can be downloaded from our university library. So please go to our university library and go to the Nimbus, the open ebooks, collection of open ebooks are available from that. Please search for the Computer Networking Principles and Protocols. So you can try to download the entire book. And the contents of today's presentation is from the chapter 1 and chapter 2. Thank you.